In this lecture, I am going to convert this Prime problem into Dwan problem and use the simplex method to get the solution. So let's convert this Prime problem into Dwan problem. So we have minimization case. This is my Prime problem. So I have a case of minimization. So I have to convert this into a standard form. So standard form in case of minimization, on the constant must have greater than equal to sign. Then in the Dwan case, what we have to do, we have to maximize. That means on the constant will be having less than equal to sign. Okay, so I have this constant that is having less than equal to sign, this is having greater than equal to sign. So I have to change this one. So I multiply this by minus 1. Okay, let's do that thing. When I multiply this with minus 1, okay, it will be plus y1 plus y2 greater than equal to 2n. Okay, so I am doing here directly. So I convert this into a standard form. Now I will set up my Dwan problem. What will be my objective function? Net x1 and x2 be variable, my decision variable in Dwan problem. Okay, let denote objective function by z, and here I have minimization case. Okay, I have converted it into standard form, so I need to use the maximization case. So I have to maximize my objective function z. Okay, so whatever you have in the right hand side in the constant will become my cos coefficient in the objective function. So I will be having 2nx1 plus 16x2 subject to constraint. Okay, so whatever constraint you have, okay, I will take the transpose of the element and I will write here. So you have 1 1 2 1, so take the transpose, it will be 1 2 1 1. Okay, so I will write here x plus 2x1, I will be having less than equal to sign because I am doing maximization problem, and second will be x1 plus x2. So write down here, okay, this one x1 plus x2 less than equal to, so whatever cos coefficient you have will become right hand side of your Dwan problem. So it will be 12 and 16, sorry, 2n and 10. Yeah, you have 2n and 10, so I write down 2n and 10, and x1 x2 value will be greater than equal to 0. Okay, so I have converted my Prime problem into Dwan problem. Now I will be using simplex method to solve this problem. Okay, so first thing what we will do is that we will introduce snag variable. So here when we introduce snag variable, it will remove this constraint. Okay, it will convert the constraint into equanimity. So by adding snag variable, we will convert this constraint into equanimity. Okay, so let's write that down. So we are maximizing our objective function z, which is equal to 2nx1 plus 16x2 subject to constraint x1 plus 2x, this is 2x2 plus, for the first constant I introduce snag variable s1, which is equal to 2n, second one will be x1 plus x2 plus s2 equal to 10. Okay, and x1 x2 is positive. Okay, you can write that down. Okay, then we will construct initial simplex table. Okay, so let's construct the table. Okay, I'm explaining what I'm doing. Okay. So CJ, okay, is the cost coefficient of your objective function. Okay, cost coefficient 2n and 16 of your objective function CJ. Okay. Then you have basic variable. And CBI is your coefficient of basic variable. Then you have solution here. You will write the solution here. And here you will write ratio. ZJ is the value of the objective function corresponding to a column that we are going to derive here. CJ minus ZZ. Okay. CJ is what? Cost coefficient. ZZ is the value of the objective function. Okay. So we have to look at this term. And that we determine whether we are able to maximize or not. Okay. Okay. Now, in order to develop this table, look at this formulation. So I have introduced two variables. Okay. Two snack variables. So by introducing two snack variables, we are saying that our objective function will not change. The value of our objective function will not change. So I can write my objective function as 2nx1 plus 16x2 plus 0s1 plus 0s2. Okay. So the value of the snack variable I have placed 0. Now, the coefficient of my objective function will be 2n16 0 0. Write down here. 2n16 0 0. Okay. So before I proceed further, okay, and develop on the thing, what we are doing here. So in order to find optimality using simplex method, okay, when we are doing maximization, okay, in case of maximization on CJ minus ZZ value, CJ minus ZZ on CJ minus Z value must be less than equal to 0. Why this is the case? CJ is your cost coefficient and this is the value of the objective function. Okay. So when you can write this like this, CJ less than equal to ZZ. So when cost is less than equal to your value of the objective function, that means you are maximizing. Okay. So keep this thing in mind. So when I am able to find, when I am getting the CJ value, okay, and I am subtracting CJ value with value of the objective function, okay, I am getting 0 or less than 0, that means I am maximizing my objective function. And the solution that I will be getting will be maximizing my objective function. Okay, that is our purpose here. Since we have a maximization case, so we will focus on the maximization problem. Okay, so basic variable we have x1, x2, s1, s2, write down. X1, X2, S1, S2. Okay. Now, this side we will write basic variable as S1, S2 because we want to know when we introduce this snack variable, okay, that converts this constraint into equality, okay, whether we are getting the optimum solution or not by introducing this snack variable. Okay. So we place snack variable first, S1, S2. Coefficient of basic variable in this case, in the case of snack variable, is 0 and 0. Okay. And whatever value you have, you will write here. Okay. Whatever coefficient you have, you will write here. So with x1, you have coefficient 1. With x2, you have coefficient 2. With s1, you have 1. For the first equation, you will write it. You don't have s2 here, so you write 0. For the second one, 1. 1, you don't have any S1, so you will write 0. Coefficient is 1. 1, you don't have S1, so coefficient is 0. S2 have coefficient of 1, so just write 1 here. Okay. Solution is 2n and 10. Just write 2n, 10. Okay. Now, so we have constructed our initial simplex table. Now, we have to find the value of ZJ. Okay. Value of our objective function. Okay, the formula to find this is ZJ is sum of I running from 1 to 2. Okay, we have two row, फर्स्ट रो सेकेंड रो ओके। कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ बेसिक वेरिएबल फॉर फर्स्ट रो एंड सेकेंड रो एलिमेंट ए रिप्रेजेंट एलिमेंट ऑफ आई एच रो एंड जे कॉमन कॉलम ओके। सो हाउ मेनी कॉलम आई हैव वन कॉलम टू कॉलम थ्री कॉमन फोर कॉलम एंड हियर आई हैव वन मोर कॉलम फाइव कॉलम ओके। सो वी विल लुक फॉर टू रो एंड ऑन द कॉलम ओके एंड फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन ओके। सपोज आई वॉन्ट टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ फर्स्ट कॉलम ओके। सो वाट इट विल बी सी बी वन ओके कॉस कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ बेसिक वैल्यू इन कॉलम वन टाइम्स ए वन वन एलिमेंट्स ऑफ फर्स्ट रो फर्स्ट कॉलम प्लस कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ बेसिक वैल्यू ऑफ सेकेंड कॉलम आई रनिंग फ्रॉम वन टू टू आई हैव डन द समेशन सो यू राइट टू हियर ओके टाइम्स एलिमेंट ऑफ सेकेंड रो फर्स्ट कॉलम ओके। सो व्हाट इट विल बी सी बी वन कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ बेसिक वेरिएबल वन इज जीरो टाइम्स ए वन वन फर्स्ट रो फर्स्ट कॉलम प्लस कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ बेसिक वेरिएबल टू टाइम्स ए टू वन सेकेंड रो फर्स्ट कॉलम ओके। सो आई विल राइट हियर जीरो इंटू वन प्लस जीरो इंटू वन विच इज जीरो ओके। सो आई विल राइट हियर जीरो नाउ जेड जू टू ओके। सो द वैल्यू ऑफ ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग टू सेकेंड कॉलम ओके इट विल बी कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ बेसिक वेरिएबल इन द फर्स्ट कॉलम टाइम्स ए वन टू ओके बिकॉज आई एम लुकिंग अप सेकेंड कॉलम प्लस कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ बेसिक वेरिएबल इन सेकेंड कॉलम टाइम्स ए टू टू ओके। सो कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ बेसिक वेरिएबल इन द फर्स्ट कॉलम इज जीरो तो राइट जीरो हियर फर्स्ट रो सेकेंड कॉलम ओके फर्स्ट रो सेकेंड कॉलम इज टू सो राइट टू हियर प्लस जीरो सेकेंड रो सेकेंड कॉलम इज वन जीरो इंटू वन प्लस जीरो इंटू वन सो इट विल बी जीरो ओके। सो इन ऑर्डर टू अंडरस्टैंड वाट वी आर डूइंग एंड अंडरस्टैंड दिस फॉर्मूला इन द फर्स्ट केस वाट वी आर डूइंग वी आर मल्टीप्लाइंग जीरो वी आर एडिंग जीरो इंटू वन प्लस जीरो इंटू वन ओके कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ बेसिक वेरिएबल इन द फर्स्ट कॉलम एंड ए वन वन कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ बेसिक वेरिएबल इन द सेकेंड कॉलम इंटू ए टू वन सेकेंड रो फर्स्ट कॉलम देन आई इन ऑर्डर टू फाइंड जेड टू सेकेंड वेन्यू ओके इन द कॉलम आई डू वॉट आई मल्टीप्लाई दिस विद दिस प्लस दिस विद दिस सिमिलरली आई विल डू फॉर दिस वन आई विल मल्टीप्लाई दिस विद दिस वन इन ऑर्डर टू फाइंड जेड थ्री एंड इन ऑर्डर टू फाइंड जेड फोर आई विल डू आई विल मल्टीप्लाई दिस प्लस दिस इंटू दिस मल्टीप्लीकेशन ओके ओके नेट डू दैट थिंग। सो वाट विल बी माई जेड थ्री जेड थ्री विल बी जीरो इंटू वन ओके प्लस जीरो इंटू जीरो इट विल बी जीरो सो नेट मी राइट इट हियर ओके वन टाइम देन नेट ओन इफ पीपल कैन डू इट। सो कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ बेसिक वेरिएबल वन टाइम्स ए वन थ्री फर्स्ट और थर्ड कॉलम ओके बिकॉज वी आर लुकिंग एट थर्ड कॉलम दिस इज माई थर्ड कॉलम ओके प्लस कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ बेसिक वेरिएबल ऑफ सेकेंड रो टाइम्स ए टू थ्री सेकेंड रो थर्ड कॉलम ओके। सो दिस इज जीरो यू कैन सी इट जीरो एंड व्हाट वी आर लुकिंग ए वन थ्री ए फर्स्ट रो थर्ड कॉलम इज वन इंटू वन प्लस ओके जीरो इंटू ए सेकेंड रो थर्ड कॉलम सेकेंड रो थर्ड कॉलम इज जीरो जीरो सो इट विल बी जीरो ओके। सो आई राइट जीरो हियर सो दिस इन मल्टीप्लाई बाय दिस प्लस जीरो इंटू जीरो फॉर द फोर्थ कॉलम ओके यू विल डू जीरो इंटू जीरो प्लस जीरो इंटू वन इट विल बी जीरो ओके। सो आई राइट इट आउट जेड फोर विल बी इक्वल टू कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ बेसिक वेरिएबल वन इंटू ए एलिमेंट ऑफ फर्स्ट और फोर्थ कॉलम प्लस कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ बेसिक वेरिएबल टू टाइम्स एलिमेंट ऑफ सेकेंड रो फोर्थ कॉलम ओके। सो इट विल बी जीरो इंटू जीरो 0 into 0 plus 0 into 1 plus 0 into 1 which is 0. Okay, so I get 40. I have finished it here. Okay, let's do for this one also, solution part also. So here also I will do 0 into 2n plus 0 into 10, it will be 0. Now I have to find the value of cj minus zj, and optimality required that on cj minus zj value must be less than equal to 0, because we are doing the maximization problem. Okay, so just subtract this term with this term. So 2n minus 0 is 0, 2n, 16 minus 0 is 16, okay. 0 minus 0 is 0, and 0 minus 0 is 0. Okay, so we have find the value cj minus zj, okay, where on are not less than equal to 0, we have positive term. Okay, that means by introducing synec variable we are not able to maximize, so we have to proceed further. Okay, so we are not able to achieve optimality, so in order to proceed further, okay, we will look at maximum value in cj minus zj. Okay, just one. So the maximum value is 16. Okay, we will look at a quantum corresponding to it. Okay, so quantum corresponding to maximum value of cj minus zj, okay, is called key quantum. This is my key quantum. Okay, next step is to find the ratio. Okay, how can I find the ratio? Solution divided by key quantum element. Okay, so we will get the ratio. Do it. Okay, let me repeat one more time. So since we are not able to find optimality, okay, maximum value corresponding to your cj minus zj value, okay, we've been having the quantum, that quantum is called key quantum. Okay, after finding my key quantum, next step we do is to find the ratio. How we find the ratio? We divide solution with element of the key quantum. Okay, so 2n divided by 2 is 6, 10 divided by 1 is 10. Okay, now the minimum value that I have, okay, is 6. So the row corresponding to it, okay, the minimum value is my key row. This is my key row. Okay, and the common point that I have in key quantum and key row, okay, is called key element. This is my key element. So in this setup, okay, I have two as my key element, okay, second quantum as my key quantum, first row as my key row. Okay, now next thing is that the row variable, okay, that I have here, say S1, will be my living variable, and the quantum variable will be my entering variable. Okay, so X2 will take the place of S1, because the key quantum variable will be my entering variable, because that is the maximum value I'm getting here as a difference, and the row value that is giving me the minimum value will be my living variable. Okay, let me repeat one more time. So I will replace S1 with X2. Okay, so S1 is my living variable and X2 is my entering variable. So net construct iteration table. Okay, So here I have coefficient of basic variable. Yeah, I have coefficient of my objective function. Coefficient of objective function cj, coefficient of basic variable, या है बेसिक वेरिएबल, ओके, देन इट विल बी द सेम दैट आई हैव हियर, ओके, 2N1600 बेसिक वेरिएबल विल मीन द सेम, जस्ट राइट डाउन हियर 2N1600 बेसिक वेरिएबल इज x1 x2 s1 s2, ओके, सिंस s1 इज माई लिविंग वेरिएबल, ओके, एंड x2 इज माई इंटरेस्टिंग वेरिएबल, सो आई विल राइट x2 हियर, x2, एंड कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ x2 इज 16, सो राइट हियर 16, ओके, एंड s2 विल रिमेन द सेम s2, एंड हियर इट विल बी 0, कोएफिशिएंट इज 0, ओके, सोल्यूशन आई हैव टू राइट हियर, रेशियो, देन वैल्यू ऑफ माई ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन बेस्ड ऑन द कोना, ओके, एंड cj माइनस zj वैल्यू, ओके, दिस इज व्हाट आई हैव टू डू, डू इट प्रॉपरली, ओके, जस्ट डूइंग, आई एम होल्डिंग द फोन एंड डूइंग इट, सो इट नॉट डन वेल, ओके, नाउ सो माई की एलिमेंट इज इन द फर्स्ट रो, ओके, सो इन ऑर्डर टू फाइंड द एलिमेंट कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग टू वेयर यू हैव द फर्स्ट एलिमेंट, ओके, द न्यू वेन्यू यू विन फाइंड इन केस न्यू वेन्यू इन केस वेयर दैट रो हैज की एलिमेंट इज न्यू वेन्यू विन बी ऑन वेन्यू divided by key element, okay, key element is the common element in your key column and key row, okay, so you have one, okay, in the first case here for the first row it will be 1/2, okay, write down 1/2, then 2/2 it will be 1, then 1/2 it will be 1/2, 0 divided by 2 it will be 0, okay, so let me write it out, 2/2 it will be 1, 1/2 is 1/2, 0/2 is 0, okay, now for second row, okay, the formula will be for finding new venue, okay, it will be on venue minus corresponding key column venue times corresponding key row venue divided by key element, okay, in this way we will find the new venue, okay, so I have to find a12 फर्स्ट रो सेकेंड कॉलम, a22 सेकेंड रो सेकेंड कॉलम, a23 एंड a33, ओके, a12 a सेकेंड रो फर्स्ट कॉलम, सेकेंड रो सेकेंड कॉलम, सेकेंड रो थर्ड कॉलम, सेकेंड रो फोर्थ कॉलम, ओके, दिस वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट, ओके, सो a21 आई हैव टू फाइंड आउट, सो ओन वेन्यू इज 1, ओके, ऑन वेन्यू इज 1, कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग की कॉलम वेन्यू इज 1, ओके, एंड कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग की रो वेन्यू इज 1, ओके, डिवाइडेड बाय की एलिमेंट इज 2, ओके, सो 1 × 1 / 2 इट विल बी 1 − 1/2 विल बी 1/2, ओके, सो आई राइट डाउन 1/2 हियर, ओके, देन आई हैव टू फाइंड ए सेकेंड रो सेकेंड कॉलम वेन्यू, ओके, सो माई ऑन वेन्यू इज 1, सो आई राइट 1 हियर, ओके, माइनस कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग कॉलम वेन्यू इज 1, ओके, कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग की कॉलम वेन्यू इज 1 एंड कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग की रो वेन्यू इज 2, ओके, सो 1 × 2 डिवाइडेड बाई 2, दिस इज की एलिमेंट ऑल्सो, सो 1 × 2 / 2 इट विल बी 0, Okay, so I write 0 here. Now, A second row third column. Okay, it is 0, so I write 0 here. Minus corresponding key column value multiplied by corresponding key row value. Okay, corresponding key column value is 1. Corresponding key row, this is row. Okay, key row value is 1. So 1 multiplied by 1 divided by key element. Key element is 2. 1 multiplied by 1 divided by 2. This will be minus 1 by 2. Okay, so I write here minus 1 by 2. Okay. In the next step, I will be doing, I am not writing A11, A21, A22, A22, A23, A24, okay, you can do it. Now next, I have want to find A24, okay, A24, second row, first column, second row, fourth column, okay, 1, on venue is 1, I write on 1, corresponding column venue is 1, corresponding key venue is 0, so 1 into 0 divided by key element 2, okay. So 1 into 0 divided by 2, it will be 1. Okay. So I write here 1. Okay. Let's take out for solution also. So for the first case, it will be 2n divided by 2. Okay. The venue is on venue divided by key element. Okay. Because key element belongs to this row. So I just write 6 here. Okay. Here in this case, solution will be, in order to find solution in the first iteration, what it will be? On venue. New solution venue will be, on solution venue is 10, okay, minus corresponding key column, okay, multiplied by corresponding row venue, okay, key row venue is 2n, so 1 into 2n divided by 2 is key element, so it will be 6, this will be 4, okay, so I write 4 here, okay, now I have to find ZJ venue. Okay, ZJ venue I have done already one step in detail, so I am just doing it directly. Okay, so 16, you know the formula. Okay, this is the formula of ZJ to find out. Okay, and here we have found out for Z1, 0 into 1 minus 0 into 1, so I get 0. Okay, so I will do here 16 into 1 by 2 is 8. Panas 0 into 1 by 2 is 0. So I will write 8 here. Okay. 16 into 1 is 16. Panas 0 into 0 is 0. So it will be 16. 16 into 1 by 2 is 8. 0 into minus 1 by 0 is 0. So I write 8 here. 16 into 0 is 0. Panas 0 into 1 is 0. So I write 0 here. Okay. Now I have to check this value. If for on CJ minus JJ, if this is coming out to be less than equal to 0, okay, that means the solution that I am getting will be my maximum, okay, will maximize my objective function, okay. So let's check it. 2n minus 8, okay, it will be 4, so it is coming positive, so we need to do one more iteration, okay. Okay, and then it will be 16 minus 16 is 0, 0 minus 8 is minus 8, 0. Okay, so in this three case we have 0 and less than 0, but here we don't have. Okay, now we have to repeat the process because we don't have find the optimality. So in order to proceed further, okay, select same process we will do. We will select the maximum venue in CJ minus JZ, which is 4. So the key column corresponding to this one, first column, okay. And we have to find the ratio, okay, using this key quantum. So 6 divided by 1 by 2, it will be 2n. 4 divided by 1 by 2, it will be 8. Okay, so the minimum venue that I am getting, okay, the key row that I will be having corresponding to minimum venue will be 8 is second row, okay, this one. Okay. So this is my key row, this is my key column, and this 1 by 2 is my key element. This is my key element. Okay. Now, I have to use this, okay, in order to construct my second iteration table. Okay. Okay, so if I turn the page, then it will be difficult. So let me use other copy, okay. Just wait. okay. So I have find my key column, key row, okay, and my key element. Next, I have to know which is my entering variable and which is my leaving variable. Okay, so the row variable will be my leading variable. Okay, it will be leaving variable. So S2 will be my leaving variable. Okay, and column variable X1 will be my entering variable. So X1 will enter here. S2 will be my leaving variable. So S2 will be leaving variable, and we will look at the optimality condition. Okay, so let's construct the case here. I have taken out the page, so I can keep it and do it easily. Page I'm moving. Okay, let's see. When you construct, do it properly, okay? Okay. This is my second iteration, okay? Second iteration table. Okay. So, let me construct this one. So this is coefficient of basic variable cj. This is basic variable. This will remain the same basic variable here. Okay, coefficient will remain the same. 2n 16 0 0 x1 x2 s1 s2. Okay, so x2 will be here. Coefficient is 16. Okay, so x1 is my entering variable, s2 is my leaving variable. So I will write x1. And what is the coefficient of x1? 2n. Okay, I will write 2n here. And here you also have 2n, okay? 2n, okay? Now, so here, okay, the key element belong to my second row, okay? So what I will do in order to find the element here, I will divide by each own value, I divide by key element, okay? So I will get the value, just find it out. 1 by 2 divided by 1 by 2 is 1. 0 divided by 1 by 2 is 0. Minus 1 by 2 divided by 1 by 2 is minus 1. 1 divided by 1 by 2 is 2. Okay. Okay. So it is easy to find this one. Okay. Here I will be having solution. Okay. I am taking out. So solution will be what I have here. Okay. So 8 divided by. Oh, sorry, 4 divided by 1 by 2 is 8. Okay, so this will be my solution. Okay, now in this case, what I have to do, if you remember the formula, okay, let me show you. This is the formula. New venue I find out, on venue minus corresponding key column venue multiplied by corresponding key row venue divided by key element. Okay, now key element is 1 by 2. Okay, for this one, okay, so I have to find A11, here A11, A12, first or second column, A13, A14, okay? So what will be my A11, A first or first column? On venue is 1 by 2, 1 by 2 minus corresponding key column. Corresponding key column venue is 1 by 2, corresponding key row venue is 1 by 2, okay? 1 by 2 multiplied by 1 by 2 divided by key elements 1 by 2. Okay, so it will be 0. So I write 0 here. Then I will find A12 first or second column. A12 on venue is 1. So I write 1 minus corresponding key column. Corresponding key column is 1 by 2. Okay, corresponding key row is 0. Okay, so I will write 0. 1 by 2 into 0, key element is 1 by 2, so this will be 1. So I write 1 here. Okay, now third, A first row third column. Okay, so first row third column, on venue is 1 by 2, so I write 1 by 2 minus corresponding key column is 1 by 2, key row is minus 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 multiplied by minus 1 by 2 divided by 1 by 2. Okay, so this will cancel out, it will be 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2, it will be 1, okay? 2 will be NCM, then it will be 1, okay? So this will be 1. Then A first row, fourth column. So on value is 0. On value is 0 minus corresponding key column value is 1 by 2, row value is 1. 1 by 2 into 1 divided by key element 1 by 2, okay? It will be minus 1. Okay, minus 1. Okay, and then what will be the solution value here? New solution value on value is 6. Okay, minus corresponding column value will be 1 by 2. Okay, 1 by 2. Row value is 4 into 4. Key element is 2. 1 by 2, okay? So 1 by 2, 1 by 2 cancel, it will be 2, okay? So write 2 here, okay? Now, we have to find objective function value, okay? And you know how to find this out, okay? So 16 into 0 plus 2n into 1, okay? It will be 2n. 16 into 1 plus 2n into 0 is 16. 16 into 1 is 16 plus minus 2n into 1 is minus 2n, okay? So it will be 4. Minus 16 plus 24. Minus 16 plus 24 will be 8, okay? So 16 into 2 is 32. 2n into 8 is 80, 96. It will be 96 and 32, 96, 100, 128. Okay, so solution value will be 128. Now I have to look at Cj minus Zj value, okay? 2n minus 2n is 0, 16 minus 16 is 0, 0 minus 4 is minus 4, 0 minus 8 is minus 8, okay? So on my Cj minus Zj value is less than equal to 0. On Cj minus Zj value is less than equal to 0, okay? So this value of x1, x2, okay, that I am getting will maximize my objective function, and the value of objective function will be 128. Okay, so the x1 value will be 2. X1 will be 2. So here x2 will be 2. X1 will be 8. Okay, and my solution value Z will be 128. Okay, so this is my solution using simplex method. Okay, I hope the process is clear to all, and just practice some more question. Okay, and I will provide the step, and I will provide the solution that I have done here on these pages, okay, in the Telegram group.